Hello everyone, God bless you. Thank you so much for joining me on my YouTube once again. God bless you. Please, if it's your first time watching my video, don't forget to hit the button or subscribe. It's below that of the video. It's not difficult since you are not going to pay for it. That is the one that wrote with red over the below down of the video. That's the subscribe. It's just for you to press it like this. It's finished. And the bell behind on it is very important. You press the bell. That's the notification bell. That is the bell that will notify you that I'm online, I'm on live, or I put anytime I load video there. Thank you so much. I do really appreciate your subscribe. Please don't forget to share. Don't forget to share it. You may not need the video, but someone out there may know the video. You never know who the video may be help. When you share the video, the video bless someone out there. You will see how God will bless you so much. Thank you and God bless you. Those that already subscribe to my YouTube, God bless you. I so much appreciate you. Thank you so much. The name of my YouTube once again is Do Not Give Up On Your Dream, Joy TV Mama P. Do not give up on your dream, Joy TV Mama P. You don't have to give up in any situation, in anything that you are passing through on this earth. Don't give up. Room doesn't build in a day, or house doesn't build in a day. When you exercise patience, sky will be your limit. But when you give up or you try to imitate people that live, a lot of people in this world right now, because of this social media of things, they are living a lot of fake life. But don't imitate them. Just be who God created you to be. Don't give up. Don't let attractive or someone else you don't know the life you live behind closed door, or to you to give up in any situation that you are passing through. All this Facebook of a things, because of flashy thing, all those kind of stuff, you don't really know the life they are living behind closed door. It make you to give up on your situation. Don't give up. Just hold on to God and trust God that with God all things are possible. God that bring you so far, you believe it, that you are the seed of Abraham. God is going to perform a great miracle in your life. That if you don't give up, thank you so much. And God bless you. God bless you so much. God bless you. God bless you. Tonight, we are going to talk about very amazing message tonight. Don't forget to share the video. Please share the video. Subscribe to my YouTube. Subscribe to my YouTube. Those that already subscribe, I so much appreciate you all. You guys are so amazing. God bless you as you subscribe. God bless you as you already subscribe. Thank you so much. Do not give up. You don't have to give up. Why are you giving up? You don't have to give up in any situation. Thank you and remain blessed. Before we start our program, we always pray to commit it in the hands of God, because Bible said, pray without ceasing. We always have to pray. In any situation you are passing through, put God first. When you put God first, you will never give up. When you put God first, sky will be your limit. No matter anything that you are passing through on this earth, every individual have problem in different ways. But when you put God first, when you trust God, you pray without ceasing. According to Book of Thessalonians, he said, pray without ceasing. You will see your at the end of it, no matter how, not how they start, how you end it is more important in life. When you put God first, at the end of it, sky will be your limit. Don't give up. Join me in prayer right now in anywhere that you are. There is no distance in prayer. No distance in prayer. In any time you watch the video, join me in prayer. Join me in prayer. Don't commonize prayer. Don't say, who is this that is praying? Or who is praying? No, don't commonize any prayer. Prayer is powerful. Agreement prayer is powerful. There is a time we come. It's just only prayer to pray for every situation that anyone is passing through. It's good to pray. Prayer is very, very important. There is nothing like prayer on this earth. No matter what you did on the past, you think, oh, if you pray, God is not going to answer. Who told you that God is not going to answer? Bible says, all things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. When you surrender yourself to God, you made that confession. Say, oh, God, I come to you with my oil, my heart, in everything. No matter what, all those passing that you don't, God is totally, we clean it. He's not a human being. We clean it whiter than snow. He will clean it. Your life will be so white. You will not have to be let that spirit to come inside you to say, oh, did you remember the sin you committed yesterday? You cast that spirit out. Say, no, it's not you, that now you are a new creature in Christ. You are not a born again in Christ. You cast that spirit out of you. You always trust God. It's very, very important. We have to pray right now before we start our program. God bless you as you join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you, King of Glory, Jehovah El Shaddai, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Elohim. Father, we thank you, King of all kings, Lord of all lords. As I am about to start the program right now, Lord, Father, I commit this program into your hands to take absolute control. Father, don't let me speak by my own. Let your Holy Spirit to speak through me. Let the words to bless someone out there in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. I bless everyone hearing the sound of my voice. Those that subscribe to my YouTube, those that are about to subscribe, those that are sharing my video, I bless them, oh God. Supply their needs according to your riches and glory. And rebuke every devil in their way in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover everyone hearing the sound of my voice with the precious blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It's always good to pray. I introduce my YouTube once again. Do not give up on your dream. Joy TV Mama P. My Facebook name is Gallant Mama Balogun or Gallant Mama P. You know, I have two Facebook. The other Facebook, I don't really accept people of that. I always accept people, most of the time, I accept people with the other Facebook, Gallant Mama Balogun. But the other Facebook, Gallant Mama P. I don't really accept people. People I have said there is my personal person, you know, that is my private Facebook, you know. You can just follow me on my new page on Facebook. It's amazing. It's good to read. A lot of people doesn't know that. You know, for example, on this YouTube, for example, I come out here, I say, oh, I make all those kind of stuff, you know. Oh, everywhere you will see a lot of people here everywhere. I don't even need to tell you to subscribe. Oh, they want to see what is going on. No, but you know, follow me on my page, new page. Read things that will encourage you, that will motivate you, that will make you to not give up in any situation that you are passing through. Is good to study, it's good to read. That's why readings help a lot. It makes some things, so there's a lot of things that you read that will reduce your stress. That things will say, oh God, you will reduce your stress. You will see people that what you are passing through that moment. There's a lot of people that pass those things, that come out, that write those novels, that write those things, that make those, that come out, that bring those ideas. Nobody, it will say, oh, it doesn't have anything. We just offering that is not equal. It pass each other, you know, not one. But when you don't give up in any situation that you are passing through, your sky will always be your limit. A lot of people are passing through different situations. When some don't even see someone to tell, but some just pretend, wearing markers, all those kind of things to make sure they are happy, but inside their heart, they are dying in silence. That is not so nice. Please follow me there on my YouTube, on my Facebook page. That is my new Facebook page. Follow me on my new Facebook page. You will really enjoy it. You will really enjoy it so much. You enjoy it. This is my new Facebook page. I just opened it this year. This is my Facebook. I'm using it right now. I opened it this year. It's not quite long, you know. I really appreciate those that follow me on that be on my Facebook, but not all. So I'm there for one reason and the other. But you guys are still amazing. But follow me on my YouTube. Subscribe to my YouTube. Thank you so much as you do. God bless you. Here on my YouTube, we talk about anything that God concerning Christ, concerning God, about your situation, for you to not give up, for you to know that you are seed of Abraham, for you to know what God talk about your marriage, for you to know what God talk about your new journey, for you to know what God talk about your little business that you want to give up, that you don't have to give up, for you to know your dream, to not give up on your dream, to not give up on yourself. For you to know God created you for a purpose, for a purpose. God created you for a purpose. That no matter how tense you are passing through right now, you don't have to give up. That you don't still have to put trust in any human being. Put trust in God. Try to do something. Don't rely on human being to say, oh, he's going to do it. He's the one. No, do things for yourself. You know, it's very, very important. Because Bible still said that in book of Proverbs, there is no food for a lazy man or a man that slept. He will end up in poverty. Sometimes you don't have to depend on people. Oh, my sister is in abroad. My sister is this. My sister is this. My brother is this. You don't have. You always sleep 24 hours to say no. Try to do something for yourself. Don't depend on anybody. Thank you and God bless you. Thank you so much. My program today is about men. I know some men may not like it because of what I'm going to say today, but the truth has to be told. It's what God said. There is no me and you that said that. It's what God said. I always see certain things that concern about Christ. What Jesus said or what God said, what they read in the Bible. Now today we are going to talk about marriage. It's very important that we have to, even though a million of thousands of this earth is talking about marriage, it's not enough. It's not enough. We have to talk about marriage because this time around, I see a lot, especially on this social media, I see a lot of video every day. A lot of people send me video. Sometimes I reply to tell them, no, I'm not on YouTube because of this. I'm not on live video because of this situation, because of this. No, I'm not going to say this kind of stuff. A lot of people called me, even though when I was my break yesterday, I received more than 4 calls. Oh, why you don't say it like this? No, I said, no, I'm not on my YouTube because of this situation. I'm not on YouTube because of this type of thing. I'm on live on my YouTube or sometime on Facebook for you to not give up, for you to know the purpose that God created you in anything that you are passing through, for you to not give up. It doesn't mean that it's not that I'm looking for fans or those kind. I have a lot more than 800 requests I didn't accept. No, but if it's one person or two person that get it, it's amazing. The Bible says that when you have a lot of multitude in your church, but when you lose one, when you have a lot of sheep, when you have a lot of sheep, it's talking about church, you know, not just, it's a parable, it's not just your sheep or those kind of stuff. That when you lose one, when you go leave those multitude, go out there and look for that one sheep, that one person, that your reward will be wide. Perfect. We please God more than any other thing. That is more important in life. Not how crowd, how fans, or those kind of stuff. A lot of crowd of fans that didn't get anything, and a lot of negativity people. No, for me, I don't love those kind of people. I don't even mingle with. If I see that you are so negativity, all those kind of stuff, you are a negative person, I will just stay clear of. Stay clear. I'm the last person to make any more quarrel with somebody, but I will avoid you. No, I'm very good to avoid. I just avoid you. But it doesn't mean that you are my enemy. Anytime we see, oh, we greet each other, but I will just avoid you, give you gap. That is me. Sometimes Bible says, my people perish for the lack of knowledge. We have to be wise. This video is concerning about men, marriage. We are going to talk about marriage. Men, I'm going to talk about today. Because people think, oh, some women are single, all those kind of stuff. Because I remember those days, our mother, before you see a single or see the single mother, they are shouting everywhere right now. It's difficult. But now, why is it so common? Why? No, me, I believe there is no woman on earth. I said it on my last video about the time I just started this YouTube. I started this year. When I started this YouTube, I said it on my video before. There is no woman that really want to become a single mother. No, for me, I don't believe it. I don't believe it. There is a woman that really want to become a single mother. Is it because of money? How much did they pay? People talk about benefit. How much? I don't really see how much they receive in their benefit of a kid. How much? It's not nothing. When you want to do shopping for your kids, all those kind of stuff, how much? There's no money there that will make a woman to decide that so they want to be a single mother. For my opinion, I don't think it's because of that, because I don't see any money. Because I believe most of women are still going to talk about it. You have to open an account. You don't have to be eating your children's money. You have to open an account there. You and your husband, that is what I'm going to talk about men today, that fight for kindergarten or children's money. Plan for your children's future. Because when they become 18 years, if we have those opportunities in Africa, we will not come here. We don't have those opportunities. It was so amazing. God said, we thank God that we are here right now. We have those opportunities to plan for your children's future, to open account. If you have 4 kids or 5 kids, open account for every individual, all of them. Open account with their name until they reach 18 years. Don't touch it. Don't let hungry. Don't let any situation for you to touch it. You know, you open it for them. At the age of 18 years, they will become something in life. They will see, they will become something, they will be amazing. You must not say, because they are paying all those kind of stuff. When I just one video someone sent to me today, it pissed me off because of kindergarten. You are crying for the children's benefit. Because of that, you are shouting, you are disturbing the woman online on social media. That is so, it's so horrible. It pissed me off, you know. The kids have to have, you have to plan for your children. Plan for your children. When they reach 18 years, they will not suffer the way you will suffer. They will not. They will have something to start up. You plan for them to go to university. Do you think the during university government is going to take care of that? No, you are the one who have to bear your own cross. That is the reason right now, when you are receiving kinder's money, children's money, or kindergarten, I don't know what they call it, another country here, they call it kindergarten or kinder benefits. Save it for them. Open account, go to bank, open the account with their name, save it, write sign there that until they reach 18 years, you don't have to. I know that is of course you can able to take it, but don't take it, leave it for them till 18 years. When they reach 18 years, they will have something to start up, they will not struggle the way you struggle. That's why it's amazing that you have your kids here. You have to plan for them. Plan for them is very, very important. As men, as surprised I hear sometimes, I say men, they fight their wife because of kindergarten, why, or children benefit. Why can you do that? You don't have plan for your children. Or, you know, I'm not talking about women today, I'm talking about men. You know, you have to respect women. It's what Bible said. I'm going to read it. We are going to study Bible together. There's a lot of responsible men, but most of, out of 100%, oh my God, some are so bad. Fact, I remember one told me last year, he don't even know how much his kindergarten. I said, what? I said, woman, you don't know how much? He said, no, their money is going to his husband's account. He's afraid he can't ask. Jesus, you are afraid of your husband, you can't ask. Bible says husband and wife is one. You people have one. You people are one, you are one flesh. How can you say you are afraid? You people have to live like brother. You play together. I'm married, I have a husband that is so much glorified God. We play, we talk to each other, we tease, all those kind of stuff, we joke, all those. That is how husband and wife supposed to be living. Understand each other. No little thing, you have problem with your wife, the first thing you have to talk, you call his mother, you call his family, you call your family. No, you are damaging your marriage. You don't have to bring your wife to public or to your parents or to anything. When you marry, someone else is at fear in that marriage. That marriage is only by God's grace the marriage will stand. So men here in Europe, many like that, you don't really, if you know you don't really love a woman, why are you going there to say, oh, I love you, all those kind of stuff? Why? You don't do that. You don't do that. At the end of it, you promise a heaven and earth when you fall. You know, some women can make mistakes 100 times before they even realize that. I'm going to talk about women, you know, when you make mistake. No, adjust yourself. Sit down. Don't rush. I'm not talking about that today. Don't rush. sit down to realize the mistake you make and wait upon God. Pray, thank God. And you made mistake for the past, but this time around, I need my own. God will definitely do it. You don't make mistakes first time, second time, third time, all those kind of stuff. That is stupid. It's not nice. But now today, I'm not talking about women today. I'm talking about men. You men, please, you guys have to respect women. Woman is not your slave. No, it's not your slave. You raise your hand up. Well, this is, I don't know what to say. It's a gift. God is a gift of it. I see some women, they are dying in silence. A lady told me last week about, oh my God, I will hold my head. You are passing through days in your husband's house. No, lady, but I don't advise any woman to call police for your husband. There's a lot of organizations like a therapy. When your husband is misbehaving, go there, go and report your husband. They doesn't have anything to damage. They will write you and your husband, or they call you guys. They will make time. They will talk to you people. They can take about 6 months. Government is paying for it to tell your husband, you are not living in Africa, in your country. This is the law. This is the way you have to live. This is the way you have to follow your wife. This is the way you have to do things at home. Follow your family. Not to you to be calling police for your husband, those kind of things. I'm not supporting that. There's a lot of different organizations here. When your husband is misbehaving, that you can take your husband to. They will cancel you people. It will take 6 months or 4 months to be going there once in a week. It's very, very important. It help a lot. It help a lot. We are living in a civilization world, you know. Some men, what I'm saying, I've read bad friends. Bad friends can destroy your marriage. Bad friends. They can use, I said it before in my last video, bad friends can use jealousy to destroy your marriage. You never knew that. Maybe they are jealous of your wife or those kind of stuff. They will destroy your marriage. I watched some videos say your wife is too fat, your wife is not beautiful, all those kind of stuff. When you approach that woman for the first time, you don't know this not beautiful enough. You don't know that it's fat. You don't know that it's skinny. You don't know why before, because you can't have kids, all those kind of stuff. You don't use it already because you have no, you now you see that it's tall. It's fat, or you see those kind of excuse to give. You know, to live in and follow such a thing is very, very bad for you guys. You guys that are doing it, you guys have to stop. Because when you hurt a woman, when a woman cried, when it tears reach ground on the sand, believe me, it's going to be very, very bad for you. Don't do that. Don't let someone, when you approach a woman, you people are together. If this is not moving fine, the way you see that it have to move fine, you guys have to build it. One of you, if you people have kids together, the kids is little, one of you have to go to school. If that there is no chance in anywhere in a kindergarten, two of you can go to school. Let you as a man first go to school. When you go to school, do hospital. Is there very hospital? I don't know hospital for English. Here we call it hospital. Work or learn something like that. Do it. When you do your hospital, you start your work. You are working. You now your wife have to go to school too. When your wife go to school, it start hospital. When you two people have all two hospital, you see sky will be you guys limit. You know why some men don't let friends, bad friends, some friends have already have idea, they have wisdom, but they because of envy and jealousy, they will destroy your. They want to destroy your home. They will tell you, if they destroy your home, they are the first person to be laughing you in your back. You know, please, as men, don't hurt women. Bible says, love your wife the way Christ loved the church. Or you marry a woman, you send it to road to go and be fetching money for you with his body. Bible says your body is the I'm not talking about women today. I will still talk about that. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. You know, or even though you do that before, those kind of stuff, where you want to settle down and marry, let those things just remove, cast those spirits out of you, bath it away. Don't let even let your husband, let your man to even know such a thing. To even know such a thing. May we have you have to treat women the way Christ said you should treat the way Christ treat the church, the way Christ loved the church. His instruction in the Bible say, love your wife the way Christ loved the church. It's very, very important. It's very important. Book of Proverbs say, there is no food for a lazy man. You don't have to. Woman's money, it don't help you. It can't do you anything good. Work, not here. It's very, very important. You have a baby, all those kind of stuff with the different. The most important thing I see from some men, hi, when they spread their eggs, oh my God, you will say, hey, when you they spread, they have some, they have bad, evil minds. Some men will even come because of one thing and the other. I have a story for one of my girlfriend. One day I will share it, you know. Because of document, when you find out the girl doesn't, they don't have document. Oh my God. The character change. The love just vanish. It just vanish immediately. Someone when you will say, oh, I love you. I do this. Because the girl don't stay for Europe long. He don't make money. He don't do okay. But he's dressing okay. But he didn't know that this girl was not. I don't want to be mentioning those things on life, you know, because you don't know who is, a lot of people is watching. It just changed the character immediately. Call, enter. So why are you calling me? People call, you know. Someone just call me. That is the reason. The attitude just come out. You have to stop that and respect women. Because I don't believe no woman really want to be a single mother. No woman really want to be with that man, with that marriage. Me believe that every woman want to be on that man. Before a woman, we can't say because of the, people say because of benefit. How much? For me, I don't think it's how much they pay woman. Only whereas once he talk about, he said, I will go to make that video for women. Some women use it to make mistake. How much for your benefit? Put you and your husband address together. For especially this country I'm living, some husband address will be there. Their wife address will be there. Why? Because of government money. They don't want to know. They don't want government to know that she or he together, they are living together to be receiving. But how much? Pay your house rent by yourself. Work and pay your house rent. Pay your life bill. No plan for your children. You will be comfortable. You will be okay. It's very, very important. It's very, very important. When you have husband, your wife has husband, you see, how much they pay you. When you have husband, your wife has husband, the sky will be you guys' limit. Limit. Please, you stay with a lady, no matter how it is, stay with lady like this. You people plan life together. Plan life together in any country you have opportunity to be that moment. Plan life with your wife together. And have idea, think. Bible say, my people perish for the lack of wisdom. I have some friend that will bring you down. We want to damage your home. To make you to lose your precious wife that God bless you with. All women, it's the same. You may say, okay, because of another girl, you want to leave that lady. The girl may pretend, you go there, he may pretend with for you for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. The end of it, character will come out. You will still go out, move on again. You know? That is not nice. Bible say a man that find a wife find a good things. Now we have to see what Bible talk about how you should respect a woman. Because women, I hate women that disrespect women. I don't really love it. I don't love it. So we say after all, I beg it's a child, let it go. When pikin grow, it will. He will look for a papa. Hey, you think so? This is the modern world. This is the modern world. If it be that child you just ignore, you don't care about it. That is the child when you grow up, you old. That is the child that you will need the help most. That time will tell you, papa, go behind. When I need you, you was not there. Please, you people have to stop it. Stop that. See what God, Bible talk about how husband, you know, so husband, you think, oh, you leave your wife, you go and be doing immorality. It causes a lot of damage, a lot of damage. Your business may collapse, your things may not work out. You will think, oh, this is the person is causing it, this is the person is causing it. You don't know, you are the one as a man. Is the you are yourself is causing it. You are yourself is causing it. Look at what God talk about. Look at me. Let us read Proverbs. Proverbs, book of Proverbs, chapter 6, verse 26 said, it is just as a disgrace to sleep with another man's wife. You see, wherever does it, we suffer. You see, so men will be trying to go leave their wife at home. Another woman on Facebook when he's married. That is the woman that will enter their eyes. They will be using a messenger phone to call middle of the night to be disturbing all those kind of stuff. But you're with your wife. What thing attracts you? In another woman on Facebook, why you not go to market and buy it for your wife? Or you tell your wife, you dress like this, dress like this, dress like this, or make up like this, fix your hair like this, wear this kind of dress, fix your nail like this, or paint your mouth like this. It's very, very important. When you maintain your thing to your taste, you will love it. You see, he said he will suffer. You see, some men don't really know the reason their life is bent. They don't know. It's very, very important. It's the Bible that said that. It's the Bible. Deuteronomy 22:22 said, if a man is fine having sex with a woman who is married to someone else, both of them must die. You see, it's not, it may not be physically dead. It may be spiritually dead. What is anything is doing is not moving forward. You know, looking for, you are married. You are a married man. You have a beautiful kiss with your wife, all those kind of stuff. You are married. Your wife will not satisfy you again. Anything because you people are married, you is not, anything is doing is not okay with you. Now you see how fat he is, how ugly he is, how he don't dress enough, how he don't, or he's ugly, all those kind of stuff. You will be looking for another man. He said that man will die. May not be spiritual. We thank God for the law, the New Testament, but it may not be physically dead. It will be spiritually. Man, you people have to be careful. There's a lot. The Bible said, look at what it said. 1 Corinthians 6, verse 18. It says, free from sexual immorality as a man. Say, free for sexual immorality. Say, free for sexual immorality. All other sins a person commits are outside the body. You see? But whoever sins sexually, sin against his own body. Please, we may have to stop. It's the word of God. Bible says, heaven and earth shall pass away. The word will never pass away. The word never pass away. There's a lot I'm going to say about women, but now to this very particular video is for men. You know, you see my hair, my... No, please. Stay with your woman that have a baby for you. Don't turn that woman to a baby mother, a single baby mama. At the end of it, they'll say a single mother everywhere because of you behavior of men. Some men, not all, a lot of men are very, very responsible. You know, like my husband. Oh, so amazing. You know, let us see book of Proverbs. Proverbs 13 verse 4, it said, marriage should be honored. You see, marriage should be honored. Even though you are not married yet with that man, you people are planning to marry. Say, honor your wife. Let your marriage to be honored. Don't be catastrophic. No. Don't be catastrophic, fighting every day, calling police, all those kind of stuff. No. He said, let your wife be your best friend. So men can keep secret to their wife. Their wife don't even know the next thing they are planning. Their wife don't even know their pin code. Their wife don't know nothing about them. Their phone is locked 24 hours. They even put their phone, if they even have breath, they will put it there. Why are you saying it's your wife? Why you people are married? Why you people are one? Your Bible says, love your wife, treat your wife the way you treat yourself. The way you treat yourself is very, very important. It's what Bible said. Let us read another one. Genesis 2, verse 21 said, therefore, a man should leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. See, they will become one flesh, no two. One flesh. If you become one flesh, why are you hiding things for your wife? Why are you doing, please, man, do what God said. Since you will see how amazing way women are powerful. There's a lot of women that have different type of spirits. I'm going to read it. What Bible says about women that we through their spirit, they will protect you. Book of Proverbs. You know, respect your wife, proud of your wife in anywhere. Even the woman, another girl come front of you, you go party anywhere. Tell that woman, did you beautiful the way my wife is? You know those kind of things. Can you cook the way my wife cook? No matter how that woman try to come and destroy your home, let the woman know that your wife is more beautiful. Then respect your wife, treat your wife. Even though you people are not married, you people have a kid or something like that, all this thing, where everywhere come full of single mother, all those kind of stuff. You know, please, you men, when you even leave the woman, don't go outside there and spoil the woman. When you yourself are the bad head, you yourself are, because what you was expecting, you didn't get it. At the end of it, you will go there and damage the woman's name. Ah, it's not good, woman. It's like this, it's like this. You know, sometimes this tongue, it says sharper than iron. Don't do that because you don't know tomorrow. You don't know future. You don't know who will help you when you old. See, book of Ephesians 5:33 said, whoever let ear, see, this is very important. It says, whatever, let each one of you, whatever, let each one of you love his wife. Let me, Ephesians 5:33. He said, whoever, let each one of you love his wife as himself, and let his wife see that he respect her husband. You say, before respect, come, you say, you love your wife. When you love your wife, the wife will respect you. Bible doesn't say, wife, respect your husband, and husband, love your wife. You say, love your wife. There's another place, you say, love your wife, and wife, submit yourself to your husband. He put love first. You don't love your wife. You don't have respect for your wife. You treat your wife anyhow. You go her out as you like. You are for your wife present. You carry food, the color, another woman, those kind of stuff. How did you expect that woman to love you, to respect you, to honor you? No, it don't work. Somebody like me, my husband, God forbid, he cannot even do. He's not such a person. For example, I can't do that. No, I can't tolerate that kind of nonsense, that bullshit. You have to love your wife. Love your wife. I receive a lot of calls most of every day when I'm in break. I always say, no, I'm not that kind of, I don't do such video. I don't do such things on my YouTube or my Facebook. You know, a lot. Amen, please. For you, you are young. Now, during old time, we are talking, don't think about how young you is now, how strong you is, how you can. Think about when you old. It's very, very important. When you old, it's very important. Let us see what this is. So amazing. It's amazing. It's a lot. I don't know if I can finish it. It's a lot. A lot. Let me just be looking for take for important one inside. This one say husband. Okay, let me read this. This will be very, very important to Ephesians 5:33. I read before. I read now 35. Look at what 35 said. It's a husband. Love your wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for him. You see, love your wife the way Christ loved the church. Christ so loved everybody, give himself for it. That's the same. For God so loved the world that he gave the Holy Begotten Son. He said, love your wife the way Christ loved the church. Mm-mm. That is very, very bad for some men. Please try to do it. Let me read about 3 or 4 verses here, you know. That is very, very important. I will end it with woman, because I'm still going to talk about lady, how to treat your husband. Respect is very, very important. But this particular video is for men. Look at what Bible said. Proverbs 4 verse 7 said. Sorry, call. Someone called me. Proverbs 4:6-7 said. He said, do not forsake your wife. He said, do not forsake him, and she will keep you. He will keep you. Love him. He said, you as a man, love him. And she will guide you. The beginning of wisdom the beginning of wisdom is that God wisdom. And whatever you get. You see, it's the beginning of wisdom. Say love, the most important thing here. It say love him, he will guide you. Let me read it another translation. Look at it. The same Proverbs 4:6-7 said, if you obey my wise words, you see, if you obey my wise words, they will keep you from trouble. You see, if you love your wife, then we keep you safe. You see, if you love your wife, he will keep you safe. Man, you have to know that. Some men think, we are in Europe, let me maltreat this lady. If I come up from this country, I enter this one, I will get another one off Facebook, all those kind of stuff. Calamity. Woman, don't let woman cry over you. Women get different spirits, different spirits. You know, every woman having a spirit, that God spirit that guide them. That God, you see, will keep you safe. He will keep you safe. Treat woman very well. Respect your wife, or respect your fiancé, or respect your girlfriend that you want to be your wife. Don't say, oh, because you have baby, you have to ignore, you have to push in, you are fighting for money. That money is not for you, it's not for the woman, it's for those children. You have to go to bank and open an account and save it for their future. It's not for you to be going, I'm coming from, I will do women video. It's not for you to be going to party, different type of party, or doing different type of organization meeting, or it's not for the man. All those men that fight for kindergarten, shame on you. That is very, very bad. Oh, you are a lazy man, like that man in Book of Proverbs. He said, a sleeping man, he will become poor. Go and work. Do husbandry. When you have husbandry, if you had husbandry, learning or something like that, I don't know. If you have husbandry, you will not suffer for the rest of your life. Even though at the end of it, you still go your country. That safety kit, they your hand. You will use it to become great man or great woman in your country when you are old. It's very, very important. No, it's very important. Please, you plan for your future, plan for your marriage, plan for your children's future. Plan for your children's future is very, very important. to love your wife, to put your wife and your children first, not family. Leo, anything your wife do, oh, brother, see, oh, sister, see, oh, mama, see, oh, papa, see, oh. You know, it damaged marriage. Because you can't say all the 100% in your family we must love, they love your wife. No, of course, not 100% everybody must love your wife. Because you don't know who is inside that doesn't love your wife. Maybe it's that person you even carry telephone and call and tell. He will say, hey, I told you before. Hey, I tell you all those kind of stuff before. He will polish your mind to make sure the marriage doesn't work. Please, man, be wise and work with your, love your wife and build your family. And don't leave the woman and go and all those kind of, turn the women, every single mother, everywhere. Understanding matter a lot. It matter a lot. Plan, when you really love, you will love a woman for the first time, you approach of a woman. If you don't, why, if you don't, I'm surprised why, man, you don't love a woman. How can you go there and be lying and lie? I don't see a lot of different story that people tell. They will pretend all those things. Why are you pretending to a woman that you don't really love? You don't know at the end of it, things will not move on the way you expect it to be. It will be a calamity to you. Please love your wife the way Christ said you love the church. Love your wife and plan good future for your children. When they reach 18 years, they will become a youngest millionaire. Thank you so much, and God bless you for being with me on this program. And don't forget to share my video, and don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to like or leave your comment. God bless you so much. It's very good when you are married, you are about to marry, you people always pray together. Prayer can still help. Read, study Bible together, you, before you people go to bed, or have it sometimes to study Bible together. That is for the women. I'm going to make that video when I have time. Thank you, and God bless you. Don't forget to share my video. If you enjoy it, share it. It's amazing. The video may be not for you. It may be someone else. You never know who really need the video. That is very good to share. Thank you, and God bless you. I really appreciate everyone that subscribed to my YouTube. If it's your first time that come across my video, subscribe to it. Thank you so much. It's a place that we study Bible together to see what God talk about your situation, for you to not give up, that you are the seed of Abraham. Thank you so much. Till next time I come and have time to come online again. Maybe normally I always come online every weekend, Monday to Friday. I don't really have time, but anytime I just have time, like today, I just come online. Early morning, tomorrow morning, 6 o'clock. Already I'm out of bed. I wake up. You know, I leave home very early. Thank you so much. God bless you. And don't forget to share it. And don't forget to subscribe. And love your wife as you love yourself. And stop maltreating your wife. Because women really deserve respect for man. Please try to do that, and God bless. Understanding matter a lot in marriage, and put God first in your marriage. When you put God first, you will never regret your marriage. Bye-bye. God bless you.